Hello, my dear students, how are you? I hope you have seen my two videos and all the concepts of the computer language are clear to you. Today we will just do a recap of it, just small recap of them, then we will move further. We have studied about the languages. There are four types of language. First is machine, second is assembly, third is high level, fourth is fourth generation language. This was first generation language, it was second generation language, it was third generation language, and it was fourth generation language. In the first generation, that is machine language, in which we use 0 and 1, 0, that is the binary numbers, it understands only by the machine. So this is known as the machine dependent language. Second is the assembly language. In assembly language, we use the mnemonic names. Mnemonic names means we use A double D add for addition, SUB subtraction, SUB sub for subtraction, MUL multiply for multiplication. This is the mnemonic names, and this is also machine dependent language. And the third language is the high level language. That is C, C++, Java is the high level language because these languages uses the English-like words. So, it is easily understood by the users and it is not a machine-dependent language. Now, next is the fourth generation language. That is the just like a normal language which we use, that is user-friendly, that is based on the icon and graphics also. And there is no more skills is required for understanding the fourth generation language. This is also not a machine dependent. This is machine independent language. Now I think every concept is clear to you. Now I will show you the bookwork of this chapter and I will make it clear step by step. Firstly, we will be filling the blanks, then true, false, then MCQs. And after that, I will send you a copy of the answer key. I will send you the copy of the answer keys of the question answers of this chapter. And you can see that question answer and you can do that question answer in your notebooks. And I will also send you the link of this book. You can download that link in your computers also. And you can have a soft copy of your book. And you can read from that book also. So thank you. So let's move. Let's move further. Now we will do the book work of this chapter.
Let's discuss the book work that of the second chapter. Now that is the filling. Firstly, we will discuss filling the blanks. The first filling the blanks is a dash is a set of instructions which tell the computer what to do. What we call the set of instruction? Set of instruction is known as a program. So programs tells the computer that what he has to do. Then a program is a set of instructions which tells the computer what to do. The first answer is computer. And the second is the development of the computer language can be classified into dash categories. Humne language ki kitni categories read out ki hai abhi. Four. So the development of computer language that can be classified into four categories. Third is dash language consists of binary number 0 and 1. Binary number language kaun si hai? Machine language. That is the low level language that only understands 0 and 1. So here the answer of the third filling the blanks is machine language consists of binary number 0 and 1. Fourth, the dash converts the assembly language program into a machine language. We have read about the assembler, interpreter and compiler. And who converts the assembly language into the machine language? That was assembler. Then the fourth answer is assembler. Fifth, the dash language uses simple English words and mathematical operators. Which language uses English words? That was the third type of language. And which was third language? That was high level language. The answer will be high level language uses simple English words and the mathematical operators. Now the sixth, dash language use mnemonic codes or the symbol. Mnemonic codes means For addition, it will use A double D. For multiplication, it will use MUL mul. For subtraction, it will use SUB sub. So Dash language uses mnemonic name, codes and the symbol. Which language uses? That was the second language. And which was the second language? That was assembly language. So here the answer is assembly language use mnemonic codes or the symbol. Seventh, the Dash are the rules governing the formation of statements into a programming language. Dash are the rules governing the formation of statements in a programming language. Rules. Which rules we follow to make the statements in the programming language? जिसके accordingly हम programming language के अंदर एक program को लिख सकते हैं, उसके लिखने के method को और उसके लिखने के rules को हम computer में syntax बोलते हैं. So syntax are the rules governing the formation of statements in a programming language. Now the eighth, in binary language, zero means off and one means on. So these are the on and off statement states. Zero means off and one means on states. Again, I am repeating the answer. Of the filling the blanks, first is program, second is for, third is machine, fourth is assembler, fifth is high level, sixth is assembly, seventh is syntax, eighth is off and on. So these are the answers of the filling the blanks. Now come to the true and false. True and false. First is machine language is the only language which a computer understand. Computer understand only machine language? Yes, it understands only machine language. This is the true. Next is assembly language is regarded as the first generation language. No, assembly machine language was the first generation language. Assembly was not the first generation language. So this is false. Third, each programming language has its own specific rules. Yes, हर language के अपने कुछ rules होते हैं. उसके accordingly ही हम उस language के अंदर हम programming कर सकते हैं. पहले हमें उस language के syntax को समझना पड़ता है. Then we can do the programming in that language. So every programming language has its own specific rules. That is true. Fourth, compiler converts high level program into a machine language line by line. No, line by line convert कौन करता है? Interpreter. Compiler नहीं करता. So compiler doesn't convert line by line. So this will become false. Fifth, high level language program has to be converted into the machine language by the translator program. Now the high level language program has to be converted into the machine language by the translator program. Yes, who translates the high level program into the machine language? That program is known as the translator program. It is true. Now next is Fortran language uses design for business users. Nahin, Fortran language business users ke liye design nahi ki gayi thi. Mathematicians ke liye design ki gayi thi, jinko mathematical calculations karni hoti thi computer ke liye. For that Fortran language was designed. So this is false. Next, programming is the process of writing specific instructions in the computer language. Yes, program kya hai? Set of instructions. Jab mein bahut sari instruction computer language mein likhni hoti hai, then we use the programming. That is true. Now the machine language use mnemonic codes. No, machine language doesn't use the mnemonic codes. assembly language use the mnemonic codes. So this is false. Now the answers of these true and false. First is true, second is false, third is true, fourth is false, fifth is true, sixth is false, seventh is true and eighth is false. Now move to the application based questions. Kapil Arndt was a computer programming during the third generation of the computer language. Which kind of language did she use then? Third generation में हम कौन सी language use करते हैं? High level. तो which language did she can use in third generation? That is high level language. The answer of the first is high level language. Next is Sumit is trying his hands at the Java programming. Which type of language is he using? C, C++, Java. These are also a third generation language. So Java programming is an example of the third generation language. That is the high level language. The answer of both application based questions are high level language. Now move to the multiple choice question. A program written in assembly language is called assembler source program and the object program. The answer is source program. B. जब program assembly language में लिखा होता है, that is known as the source program. जब assembler इसको convert कर देता है machine language में, then that is known as the object program. Second, a dash converts a high-level language program into the machine language line by line. Who converts the high-level language into machine language line by line? Line by line convert karta hai interpreter and whole program is converted by a compiler. So answer of this is C, that is interpreter. Now the C, the program converted into the machine language by the translator is called. The program converted into machine language by the translator is called. Think about it. अभी मैंने just discuss किया है. Program convert होने से पहले that is known as the source program. When it is converted, it is known as the object program. So the answer is B. This B is object program. Third, the term software was first used by, at the last of the chapter we have read it, that John V. Takei. The answer is B, that is this. Now is it clear to you the book work of this chapter? Now here are the questions. I have given to you, but I will send you the answer keys of these questions and after this video I will send you the answer keys of this question and the answers of this book work also. To just see the answers of these questions and write down in your notebook from that. What do you mean by machine language? Machine language kya hoti hai? Wo language jo machine hi understand kar sakti hai, wo low level language hoti hai, wo zero, wo binary form mein hoti hai, that is 0 and 1. Next is, how is assembly language different from the machine language? Machine language is the binary language. Assembly language use the mnemonic codes, that is add, subtract, multiply. And the machine language use the binary code, that is the 0 and the 1. And the assembly language, machine language is a machine dependent language. And that is also a dependent assembly is also a dependent language, machine dependent language. Next is, what are the features of the high level language? That is simple, user friendly, easy to use, machine independent language, using English words, minimum efforts of the users to obtain any information. These are some features of the high level language. Next, differentiate between the interpreter and the compiler. Interpreter, who converts the source program into object program line by line, and compiler converts the whole program. This is the major difference between these two. And characteristics of the fourth language we have already discussed, that is user friendly language, that is independent of the operating system. It has a high speed of execution. Our users have, if we want to understand it, we need not to do more efforts. Its cost is also day by day, its cost is becoming less day by day. So these are the some features of the fourth generation language. So we have already discussed the bookwork and the question answer of this chapter, and I am standing with the answer key. Just see that answer key and note down these questions in your notebook also. And still, if you are facing any difficulty, you can contact me.